गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। सो टुडे विल डिस्कस द इमोशनल ईएमएफ। ऑलरेडी वी आर डिस्कस सम यस्टरडे सम फैडेस लॉ एंड लेंस लॉ। द सेम द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ पार्ट इज व्हाट द वन थिंग इज व्हाट इमोशनल ईएमएफ दैट वन। तो बी प्रियर टू दैट फैडेस लॉ बेस्ड ऑन दैट हाउ टू प्रेडिक्ट द डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट विल टेक वन एग्जांपल सी ऑफ यू। ओके रीड द क्वेश्चन नो। सो देयर इज अ बार मैग्नेट। दिस बार मैग्नेट so it is released from rest above a conducting ring and the conducting ring is fixed there. Find the acceleration of magnet for the situation shown. So first when it is approaching the ring, next when it is moving away from the ring. So let me take observer. Let me pick up the observer here. So it is an observer. Then how the lines of force, the lines of force due to bar magnet will be like this. So how B bar at this particular point will be vertically down. So from Faraday's law, again the flux is negative. At the bar magnet approach, the field strength at center of the ring will increase. So d phi by dt will be negative. So EMF induced will be positive. So this observer will see that the observer will see that observer will see that the induced current should be positive and it should be anti-clockwise. So anti-clockwise means the direction of current should be like this. Come to the Lenz law. The direction of induced current should be such that it should oppose the cause. So in the ring is having now dipole moment MR. So this should be the north pole, the upper face should be north and the lower face should be the south. Then there's a bar magnet which have MB bar like this. So north north, so it will oppose. So how the repulsive force and the weight of the bar magnet will act vertically down. So what do we expect? The acceleration increases. No, as the bar magnet approaches here, the field strength will increase. As the bar magnet approaches the ring, the field strength on the axis will increase. So B bar will increase. So negative flux increases. D phi by dt negative. So EMF will be positive. So induced current and curl fingers. curl fingers. The thumb what happened will be up. So MR due to the ring will be upward. So upper face of the ring will be north, lower face will be south. So a repulsive force will be acting on the bar magnet. This is a repulsive force. Now, so what is the acceleration of this? So what is A1? A1 we write it as MG minus F repulsive by M. So G minus F repulsive by M. So what do we expect? A1 less than G. Some value that will be less than G. After this, yeah. The magnet moves away from the ring. Then how the lines of force. Oh, no, in this case, from Faraday's law, flux will be negative. Negative flux decreases. Able to understand any reason for that? Or B bar will be directed in this direction only. So as the magnet moves away, the field strength at the center of the ring due to bar magnet decreases. As the B bar decreases, negative flux decreases. D phi by dt positive, EMF induced should be negative. So then now the induced current should flow. This observer, don't change observer because you keep observer at same point. So you will see that the current will be in this direction. Then how M bar of the ring. So this will be south, this will be north. So look at the bar magnet, south, north. So there'll be an attractive force will be acting on the ring. So the weight of the ring, mg, will act here. So tell me, like, how that attractive force, will be acting in this direction. F attractive, well, let me write here. So then also know what is the acceleration, A2 mg minus F attractive by m. So what is A2? Less than g. So both when it is approaching the ring as well as receiving, moving away from the ring, the acceleration of the bar magnet should be less than g. Let's discuss about the energy aspect. The decrease in potential energy of the bar magnet. The decrease in potential energy of bar magnet. What will happen to it? A part of it will be converted into increase in kinetic energy of bar magnet. And remaining, what will happen? Heat generated in this particular ring. This ring is having, let it have a resistance R. And also interaction potential, many other parameters you should consider. But all together, the decreasing potential energy is what will get converted into remaining all other form. If you just change the direction of induced current in the ring, things will be totally different. Law of conservation of energy will get violated. Okay, the interpretation of the Lenz law is very important here. In both the cases, the acceleration of the bar magnet will be less than g. Okay, see, everything should come in order. You try to see the way your teacher is putting all things in order. First Faraday's law, then Lenz law, then from Lenz law, what happened? You predict all the direction of the forces that are acting. Then I'll come to the laws of motion. Then I'll discuss the motion of the bar magnet. See, for namesake EMI chapter, everything again will go back to mechanics or current density. I'm making things clear. Your chapter got over long back. Yesterday only got over. The moment I write Faraday's law length, it's over. Rest on everything will come application. And there's no limit. This chapter, there's no limit. Okay, let me give. Now, if I drop a bar magnet in a long cylindrical tube, this is a iron pipe. I think it is understood, no? Iron means metal, pipe, hollow. I'll drop into that one. And it's a long iron pipe. And this end is you put better infinite. This end I should not put infinite here because I should drop from finite, no? It's a very long iron pipe. What will be the motion of the bar magnet? Take the effect of gravity. Gravity will be there. Just bring the bar magnet inside the pipe. Initially, why do it will move down? Why do it will fall down? Because of weight. Because of weight, it will fall down. As it falls down, then it will encounter the rings. No, similar, the same earlier idea you have applied. It will encounter rings. There'll be rings above the bar magnet, below the bar magnet. Those rings which are above, those rings which below. What condition they'll put on the bar magnet? That we have to see. This is the upper part. It's a long one. It's a long pipe. So the bar magnet, let's take somewhere in this position, south, north pole. The weight of that, W, let me write it here. Those rings which are above, in what direction they'll exert a force on it? Those rings which are above, so how the direction of current will be? So apply the same similar concept, how the direction of current, anti-clockwise. Current in this part of the those rings which are below Okay, I'm showing this current I. Is it okay? No. So in the upper part of the bar pipe, the current will be flowing in this, and the lower part, the current will be flowing in this direction. I'm showing things clearly. Just do notice. So put that current, need not be seen. Call I1, I2. What this I2 will do? Will exert a force F2 like this? What about this particular thing? It will also exert a force, no? Both will exert. F2 will be attractive. The upper part will exert a force F2 on the bar magnet. Upper part of the pen. The lower part, what pen will be exerting a force? That will be repulsive force. That will be F1. What can happen here? So this will have velocity V. So it will accelerate, no? So then what is the equation we can write? Ma is equal to, let me write mg. Mass of the bar magnet, mg minus F1 minus F2. Now, what can happen? What are F1, F2? Will they depend on the position as it is, as it keeps on? Initially, what when the release from rest, now what are F1, F2? Zero. So as the bar magnets accelerates, what can happen to value of F1, F2? I think this, we don't have any information, no? How to predict that F1, F2? F1, F2 on what factor depends? Force of interaction between the ring and the bar magnet. With the time, what will happen to the bar magnet? Its velocity continuously increases. No? And as the velocity increases, and what is that induced current due to rate of change of flux? What is induced current? Induced current I2, I1 or what they are? They are rate of change of flux. And the rate of change of flux depends on what? Depends also on the speed of the bar magnet. If the speed of bar magnet increases, what happens? More rate of change of flux. More rate of change of flux, then EMF induced more, then induced current is more. Then if induced current I2 is more, F1, F2 will increase. So with the time, F1 and F2 increases. Now what is maximum permitted value of F1, F2? Finally, what happens? The F1, F2, when the resultant of these two, when it becomes equal to G, the net force on the bar magnet will be zero, and the bar magnet will continue to move with the terminal velocity. After long time, so what is the acceleration of bar magnet will be zero, and the velocity of this will be, I'll call terminal velocity. It is similar to viscosity. F1, F2, F1 and F2 are dependent on speed of bar magnet. Is it justified? Because you do one thing, that ring is a one current carrying loop, and this bar magnet is also some current carrying loop. You go back to the basic thing, force of interaction between two loops, as we can find out here. The interaction potential depends also on the distance and also the speed here, no? And the I2 depends on speed. As the speed of the bar magnet increases, I2 increases, then F2 also increases. As the speed of bar magnet increases, the rate of change of flux linking the lower part of the pipe will increase. Then induced current I1 will increase, induced EMF will increase, E1 will increase, I1 will increase, F1 will increase. So both F2 are dependent on speed. Speed continuously increases. At one instant, when F1, F2 becomes equal to weight, the net force will be zero and it move with a constant speed. Just do unless maybe later part of year, after working out few numericals, you may able to write some equation. There's initial theoretically, I'm just analyzing it. So finally, what pen? It will move with a constant speed. So many of questions will be there, so you have to be careful. No? Okay, let's go for the motional EMF. And this is about the Faraday's law. Some application questions do come like this. initially F1 F2 will be less than mg, similar to viscosity. Initially F1 F2 will be less than mg, so the acceleration decreases, speed increases, and the F1 F2 depends on speed, similar to viscosity concept. Okay, now we'll what all numericals we have now. 90% of numericals are based on this motional EMF. The rest all remaining, all other things will come. A firm idea of this will really help you a lot. So now let's take a conducting rod. I'll move in a uniform magnetic field. Let me move with a constant speed V in uniform magnetic field. Let the length of this conducting rod be L. It's an iron rod. Now let the B bar be the strength of the magnetic field. Then will there be any potential difference set up across the end? So let's assume that a positive charge, of course, there won't be displacement of positive charge. In fact, it will be electron only. To make that negative signs little bit, to avoid that negative sign, I'm taking the hypothetical positive charge. If the rod moves, what is the state of this electron, or it's like a positive charge or electron? It'll be moving randomly inside this. So there's a random motion. And as the rod moves, what happens? Due to this, this will be ordered motion. Now, what will be the Lorentz force due to that random motion? Will be zero, no? Because what is the net displacement due to random motion? Will be zero. So what all that particular motion of the charge particle, net velocity of charge particle will be due to ordered motion. What is ordered motion? The velocity of the rod will be the net velocity of the charge particle inside the rod, or the net velocity of the free electron inside the rod. Due to random motion, the average velocity will be zero, or the net displacement will be zero. So therefore, the random motion, what will not come into picture here in our discussion. What is the state of the electron? It will be having random motion, and superimposed by this, the velocity of the rod. Then which will be, when I say what is the velocity of the charge per electron inside the rod, means it should be velocity of the rod only, because what is the average velocity due to the random motion, or average displacement will be zero, no? Or net displacement will be zero. So that random motion totally you can take it out. Okay, let's see that Lorentz force you apply, B bar into the plane velocity. So in what direction the magnetic force will act on this? The force will be acting in this direction. Because of this force acting, the positive charge will drift, will be pushed away to the upper end. Then gradually, with after some time, what I see that there'll be deposition of the positive charge. And here there'll be deposition of negative charge. In fact, in practically what happens, we are sure that there is nothing called like a positive charge moment, no? Because the new where do the protons be there inside the nucleus? Then what is positive negative charge? Here at the lower end, the electrons will get deposited. The excess of electrons here at the lower end is what will build up negative charge. The deficiency of electrons at the upper end will build up the positive charge. Is it okay now? I'm making things clear. Don't take it another way. The deficiency of electrons is what here? Positive charge. Here, deficiency of electrons is what? The negative charge. So because of this, there will be an electrostatic field is set up. A net electrostatic field is generated here. Then continuously this rod is being moved. So here the positive charge. What are the forces that will be acting on it? FB, hind electrostatic force. Yes or no? Why do this electrostatic force? Due to drifting of charges only. Now, how long this like a drifting of charges will occur? As long as DFB greater than DFE. Once the DFB is balanced by DFE, no longer the drifting of charges will occur. Then the amount of charge at the upper and lower end will remain fixed here. Then we'll get an electric field, and length is L. So there'll be a constant potential difference will be generated. Now we are trying to calculate that potential difference. So now at equilibrium, BFB is equal to BFE. So this is QVB. This should be equal to Q into E, that one. So this will be VB. What is E? We can write it as DE by DX. Only magnitude I'm taking. So further this DE is equal to VB into DX. The EMF induced E or right BLV. In the mathematical form, we can write it as it's a triple product, no? So there's a form, what will the EMF induce? So EMF induce what happen? It's a scalar quantity, no? Don't write E bar. It's a potential difference. V is the velocity of the rod, B bar is the magnetic field, and L bar is the effective length. So now the moving rod will behave like a source of EMF. Then which end will be positive? The upper end will be positive. So this moving rod I can replace with a cell. The upper end will be positive, the lower end will be negative. It should be a conducting rod or non-conducting rod. Non-conducting rod, no question of any free electrons. So if you move a rubber rod, we don't get any potential because there are no free electrons. So what is this? Shall I call this is the deficiency of free electron? Deficiency of free electrons. What about this end? Efficiency of free electrons. So which end is positive or negative? Either you can take help of this formula or directly take help of Lorentz force. Now you assume positive charge inside the rod. In what direction the positive charge will experience a Lorentz force? The term will be directed in the direction of the positive potential. This is called like a motional EMF. Why do this EMF is generated? Due to motion of the rod, due to translational motion of the rod. What is V? V is a translational motion. Later we'll go for the rotational effect. So now there are only situations like this, a B bar into the plane. A rod is moving. Then which end will be positive? You assume a positive charge inside it and it expends a force plus minus. And same in B bar. If I move the rod in this direction, then B bar, the velocity, so this end will be positive. The field can be out of the plane. Then B bar and velocity, so this end will be positive, this will be negative. This will be positive, negative. Just assume a positive charge inside the rod. The direction in which the magnetic force experienced by the positive charge in the rod will be the positive end. This is the best way of this one. Always take help of this mathematics. So this is about the rod. Now the initial example, let me go for the application later on. Now the shape of the rod, let's come for what is that L bar, effective length. So first case, I will take the rod. In all the cases, the length L is the effective length. B-bar is into the plane. And in all the cases, I'll move the rod with a constant velocity V along x-axis. So let this be the 1, 2, 3, and 4. What is the EMF induced in all the cases? So what is L bar? Effective length. So what is the effective length in all cases? Will be same. So E1 equal to E2 equal to E3 equal to E4 equal to BLV. The shape of conductor, it doesn't matter. Is it okay now? I think this is really going to help you a lot. So don't get scared with some different shapes. Go for effective length. So effective length from where to where we have to calculate. From here, this is effective length, L bar, B bar velocity, you know, so get the effective length or the shortest distance between the ends. Shortest distance, like a displacement. You look at this displacement. Displacement vector you calculate across the ends, that will be the effective length here. And what about the which end is positive, negative? So again, assume positive charge inside the conductor. So this end will be positive, negative, positive, negative. Now, if I move a loop, okay, this is okay. Now, if I move a loop itself, that the uniform Mansfield is there. Say very, rather than numericals, no, when you are learning itself, just see that let the radius of this be A. This is the iron ring. This is a B bar. I'll move in a uniform magnetic field. The field is uniform. What to do, like how to get the it was a rod, no? Little bit easy for us. Now you do one thing, break up this 1, 2, 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3 is what? One ring, semicircular rod, and effective length will be how much? Equal to 2A, and this also 2A. So this is equivalent to like a 2 cells. And they're moving with a speed V. What is EMF? This will be E1, 2, 3, and this will be E1, 4, 3. And what about magnitude of both? Will be equal, how much it is equal to? B effective length 2A into V. So how you replace suddenly with these two? So this part of the ring, semicircular ring, no? What is the effective length? Will be 2A diameter, so BV into 2A. Even this also effective length. How much the effective length of this will be 2A. So B into 2A. Then how to give polarity? You assume here positive charge. All of you see left hand, Fleming's left hand rule is very important. See, all these things not by seeing, your left hand should be free. F equal to BIL, then F equal to Q, V bar cross B bar, the left hand should come. When you're using cross product, the right hand should come. If you twist your arm, there should be a pain in your left arm. Then only you are learning EMI chapter. Left hand open, another 2 weeks, a pain should come. You should apply the Zendo bomb. Where to apply that one? Your arm. This one, the here, no? Exactly at this turning point. So at the fist, what happened? You should apply the Zendo bomb because almost every problem needs Fleming's left hand rule, F equal to Q, V bar cross B bar, E equal to V bar cross V bar dot L bar. So if there is a pain in there, as you have put effort. If there is no pain, then okay, finish. You become accountant, not engineer. Don't see things. No, the left hand should be there. So now take left hand. Let there be a charge here. Put positive charge. Put finger B bar in the direction of the ring, in the direction of B bar. The pointing finger. Thumb, pointing finger, middle finger. I think this everyone knows. So now put that one. Then open middle finger in the direction of velocity. Look at the force. The thumb will point upward, no? So the thumb will point in the direction of positive potential. So therefore, the upper end is positive. So directly you can give the polarity. This will be positive. This will be negative. And replacing with the effective EMF. tell me what is the net EMF induced in the loop. You write KVL E123 minus E143 equal to 0. And magnitude is equal, no? So therefore, what is the EMF induced in the loop? E123 minus 0. If the ring is having some resistance R, let's assume. So here, how much of resistance can bring R by 2, R by 2? What is the current in the ring? Will be 0. Half of the resistance will come for 1, 2, 3, 4, remaining of will be 0. So here, I put R by 2. What is R? Resistance of the ring. Any current in the ring will be 0, no? No current flows. Different shaped loops, different shaped rods, they'll be moving in uniform magnetic field, non-uniform magnetic field. Stick onto the basics. Effective length is what matters here. Okay, let's take some. Let this be around. Magnetic field strength. Let the length of the rod be A and let this be B. I'm moving with a velocity V bar, where V bar is given by Vx I cap plus Vy j cap. We have to calculate the EMF induced across the rod. Okay, it should be the 1, 2, 3. E13 I won't. Let me write 1, 2 and 2, 3. Let's come back to the basics here. Suppose if this is a B bar is into the plane, and I'll move the rod along its length. What is the EMF induced across the ends? 1, 2. Go back to this formula. E bar equal to V bar cross B bar dot L bar. V bar cross B bar. How V bar cross B bar will be? Check it. Will be along Y axis. BV J cap. So here, let me define the coordinate axis. Is it okay? Curl V bar towards B bar. Thumb will be along Y axis. So BV J cap I'll write it. Dot product. This should be L I cap. So BV L J dot I should be zero, no? So therefore, no EMF induced across the rod 1, 2. Sir, will there be any EMF induced between 3, 4? If it's a thin rod, then what is the length L? What is the width of the rod? Will be zero, no? Of course, EMF induced 3, 4 will be non-zero. It depends upon the width, the thickness of the rod. If the thickness is appreciable, yes, you can go for it. If thickness negligible, then you have to put E340. Fine. Look at this. This is very important. When thin rod, thick rod, you have to make observation. Everywhere rod is conducting, so non-conducting I will mention. Loop, whenever I say loop, rod, anything, no, it should be conducting. If it's non-conducting, I'll mention separately. Okay, now thin rod. Thin rod of L shape. Is moving in a plane is moving in a in an uniform magnetic field as shown. Find E13. I want EMF induced across the hands 193. Okay, thickness difference is there. I made same thickness. Thin rod is telling us, so we need not to bother about the thickness now. First, we'll analyze one by one. So first, we'll look at only E12. E12. So how is the X component? So for E12, for the only so this is rod 1 2. Two types of fields are there, no? One BY, another is BX. Then it is having X component of velocity, another Y component of velocity. So let's check it now. So B bar and V bar are in same direction. Now look at this particular thing. How due to Y component of this? First we'll calculate due to X component of field, X component of velocity. Y component of field, Y component of velocity, they'll be zero. Now X component of velocity and Y component of field. B bar cross B bar, you check it. Straight away, I suggest you to use this formula. It's very easy. V bar, Vx cross Bx will be zero. By cross By will be zero. Agreed? Then Vx cross By will be non-zero and all be directed along Z axis. And how is L bar? L bar is along Y axis. Dot product of two vectors perpendicular will be zero. So you take all the combination. E12 will be zero. Similarly, you break up the problem. 2, 3, Bx, this will be By, and we have a field Bx and By. So what is the EMF induced in the rod 2, 3? V bar cross Vx cross Bx will be zero. Vy cross By will be zero. Then Vx cross By will be non-zero. And how will it be directed? Be directed along Z axis. But L bar is measured along X axis. There will be zero. Similarly, Vy cross Bx will be along native Z axis. L bar is along X axis. Dot product will be zero. So I'm very sure that from the mathematics, E12 zero, E23 zero. So net EMF induced. This is about this one. If B bar were into the plane, things will be different. If B bar were into the plane, things will be different. Is it okay? I think this formula, you have to take help of this formula. You mean to say here, this one, or here, this one. You mean to say this one, E31. Say, what all EMF induced? I'm just adding up due to individual rods. This one only. साई शेखर, सम नॉट दिस वन, ईयर यू मीन टू सी? हाँ, व्हाट इज E13 अगेन? E13 और E12 बोथ आर सेम, नो? व्हाट यू मेजर फॉर E12, सेम थिंग फॉर E13, सो यू राइट इट फॉर E13 अगेन द सेम थिंग, वी बार क्रॉस बी बार, वी बार क्रॉस बी बार, इट बिलोंग नेटिव दैट एक्सिस, सॉरी पॉजिटिव आई एक्सिस, एंड जे कैप क्रॉस आई कैप will be zero again, same thing. So what you do for E12 or E13, both will be same. E34 will be non-zero. Thickness negligible, that's why I have put very small value. Now the same situation. These are some types of objective questions are being asked in advance. That's why I just stressed once. So you try to assume the different types of structures, different types of fields. Rather than you fight with a question, you better analyze. And now the same thing. So let the B bar be into the plane and the velocity of the rod, let me give Vx I cap, By J cap. Let X be the length of this part, Y be the length of this one. So I want the E13, or let me write EPQ. So look at the B bar is uniform and into the plane. If you're getting confusion, go for individual or directly take a formula, B bar cross B bar dotted. So let me just break up EPO. This is related to that one. EPO due to X component will be there, and also due to Y component will be there. As it is a thin rod, no? So therefore there's a thin rod. So velocity, component of velocity along the ends, what happens, should not be, EMF due to that will not be considered. So therefore EPO will be only due to BV X into Y. Then EOQ should be equal to BVY into X. Will I agree this? As it is a
that
thin...
That should be VQO, sir.
Oh, okay, the symbol, huh? Yeah. EPO, I'll write it. So positive, look at this one, B bar and the velocity. So this will be positive. Negative. Then B bar and velocity. So this end will be positive, this will be negative. I think I'm right.
So it should be EOP.
Why you are writing like this? B bar finish or NP is positive, endo is negative.
Sir, we are measuring distance from O to P, no, sir?
No, not like that. I'm writing potential difference. I think you must understand. I'm writing potential difference. I'm writing potential difference. So what is the net potential difference? EPQ, EPQ should be equal to EPO. So I'll move from positive to negative, then positive to negative. So shall I take difference or shall I add up? This is equivalent to like a cell. Still, if you unable to make it out, so you do one thing, replace this. So when you move from P to Q, minus EPO plus EOQ. I'll write it. Loop equation EP minus EPO minus EOQ minus EO. All set equals 0. So therefore EPO EPQ should be equal to EPO plus EOQ. Add up these two. So BVXY plus BYX. Able to make it. So just do one thing, replace with a cells, positive and negative terminal. How to replace positive terminal? Again, the same thing. Assume a positive charge inside the conductor and then proceed into the problem. And get the polarity, then apply KVL.
Sir,
so
how did you get E, sir? I mean, like, why did you take VX only, sir, there? We have to take cross product, no, sir.
Component of velocity along the rod will not contribute EMF. Because thin rod, no? Straight away, I'm just going for a simplified approach here. As it is a thin rod, component of velocity along the length will not contribute EMF as a thin rod. Am I right?
Okay, sir.
So here, what are the things? There are two velocities, are there Vx and Vy. No, you look at carefully. Why we are not taking EMF due to Vy? Because it is along the length, no? Vy is parallel to L bar. Here Vx is parallel to L bar. Component of velocity along the length of thin rod will not contribute EMF. Okay, ma? This is? So the thin rod is very important. So different types of questions, different shape of rods moved in a magnet field. What is the EMF induced? You have to be different. And sometimes you get a let L be the this one. What is the EMF induced? Component of velocity only. Equal to B L V cos V sine theta. Why? Due to V cos theta, there is no EMF. E12. Because component velocity along the length of the rod will not contribute EMF. I'm writing BLV sin theta. I'm just what all, this is another example what you can take help of it. So when the velocity of the rod is not perpendicular to length of the rod, then component velocity perpendicular to length of the rod will contribute EMF. Now, what is E bar electric field inside? I think we can calculate, no? From the very first formula. So what is electric field inside? V into B, no? If velocity increases, the field strength also will increase. Please do notice. How much of electric field strength set up in the conducting rod moved in a magnetic field? Velocity into the magnetic field strength. This will be very troublesome for you. Try to think something electrostatics. Take help of this motional EMF. Okay, altogether, the moving rod I'll replace with a cell of EMFE. So let's take the application part. Here is what you'll get. N number of problems for you. All different cases will come. So I'm starting like this. There's a rod PQ of mass M. And length L. Initially, what happened? It is at a certain position, and these are long rails. These are the long rails. Now, what will happen to, and there's a resistor. In place of resistor, you connect a bulb or a heater coil. Anything, it can be that one, which will consume electric power. This was the rod. For this rod PQ, I'll project this rod PQ with a velocity U at T equals 0 and release it. Then he's asking all the things. find the expression for induced current, speed of the rod at any time, and total heat generated in the resistor R. There's no resistor for this conducting rail, similar to railway track is what you should assume here. And that B bar is uniform. B bar, there's a first problem, please first try to understand, because all the numericals are related to this diagram only. B bar into the plane or out of the plane. Rod given velocity towards left, towards right. There's no resistance of the conducting rails. Time being, we'll assume that no resistance. Then let's first apply the Lenz law. Flux negative. And as the rod moves, as the rod shifts towards right, negative flux increases. d phi by dt. Negative. EMF induced will be positive. So how the induced current should flow now? Induced current in the rod should flow in anti-clockwise. Now, moving rod, we used to replace with a cell. So here I'm bringing a cell. Now, sir, you didn't give any cell, suddenly you brought it. So what is the basic idea? A moving rod will behave like a source of EMF. A moving rod will behave like a source of EMF. There's a motional EMF, that one. So I'm writing V also nearby it. Then what is the expression for current now? I equal to E by R. Now, suddenly from in place of rod, what has come? The cell. So this, you write it rod only. It is the impact rod only. And now, if I'm right, according to Lenz law, the direction of induced current should be such that it should oppose the cause. What is the cause? What is the cause? The velocity. So there should be force opposite to it. You apply again BL, left hand. So how the force will act in this direction. Now this force acting on the rod, now what it'll do, it will make it to retard. This is at t equal to 0. This is at any time t. Now let's write the equation. Now we have I is equal to, so what is minus MA is equal to BIL. What is I is equal to? E by R. Oh, this is minus M dV by dt B. dV by V is equal to B square L square MR dt. Now let me go for the integration. All this constant, BLM are constant. So this is dt. What is the initial velocity given u? At any instant of time, let v be the velocity. So v equal to u e to power of minus lambda t. So this is the speed of the rod at any time t. When do the rod will come to rest? After a long time. Let's, is asking expression for the speed, then current I. We know I is equal to BLV by R. Look at the current. Is it a constant current? No, a variable current. And finally, what happened to rod? Rod will, after a long time, put T equal to infinity, the rod will come to rest. Then what happened? All the kinetic energy given to the rod converted as heat is available as heat in the resistor R. So therefore, total heat generated in the resistor R. There are two ways you can calculate that heat. Total heat generated H. One, you can go for I square R dt 0 to infinity. Or directly shall I write initial kinetic energy given to the rod, because that only what point will be converted into the heat, that one. So let's assume this is a bulb. You project with a speed u. Then what will happen to intensity of bulb? I'll project the rod with a speed u. What will happen to intensity of the bulb? If there's a bulb, what will happen to intensity of the brightness of the bulb? Will gradually decrease, no? So let instead of R, let this be a bulb. So these are the questions which are troublesome for you. In place of resistor, they'll give a bulb, and this is a rail. the bulb will have the resistance and there's a rod PQ and these are rails. No, I'll ask you to plot brightness of the bulb as a function of time. Initially, it will have brightness and it will gradually decrease. When the bulb will stop glowing at T equal to infinity? That's what the equation says. No, when current is zero at T equal to infinity. There's a question available in book like this. For exams, it will be of this kind. Application. What all you learned? Okay, how you manage, you know. So the bulb will have resistance R, no? So that R is can be ether coil, can be a bulb, can be any other circuit. Please do make notice of these kinds. No? First learn it and try to generalize. It'll be better for you. Okay, there's a very first problem. Almost every problem, the idea will be like this. So very simple. These are the what? The Lenz law. Once you get the direction of induced current, the rest of everything is laws of motion. You should interpret with the help of the mathematics here. Okay, just see once I'll... shall we say no power... what is the role of BIL? Yesterday only I just discussed. Once again, let me focus here. What is the role of BIL? BIL force does negative work, no? Where it has gone? So BIL is some sort of agent. What it do? It converts kinetic energy of the rod into electrical energy. And the resistor, the bulb, what it do? Will convert electrical into thermal energy. Very important. Do stress on this. What is the BIL? BIL force converts kinetic energy of the rod into electrical energy. So I think I'll stress that particular point here. Any conceptual questions can stress you. BIL force acting on the rod PQ converts kinetic energy of rod into electrical energy. Okay, let's take another. Read the question. Previous case, we moved the rod with a constant speed u. Now I'm going to move the rod. Rod was given velocity u and released. Now what about here? I'm going to move with a constant speed u. Then again, the equivalent circuit. The moving rod. What we do with moving rod? The moving rod will replace with a cell of EMFE. There's a B bar. There's a resistor R, and the induced current here will be in this direction. And how BIL force? BIL force will act towards left. How to maintain the speed of the rod constant? I must apply some external force here, no? Then only possible. An external force must be applied. They should balance BIL. Then only the speed of the rod will be constant. And where the rod gone? This is a rod. This itself is a rod. And then again, we know current will be anti-clockwise by Lenz law, everything. And what is E? E equal to BLU. And what is I? I equal to E by R. So BLU by R. Then external force, how much I should apply, which is equal to BIL. So this will be BLUR into L. Power generated by external agent. affectional into u. B square L square u into u. Where does this power go in? So let me go for power dissipated in this circuit. Dissipated. Electric power dissipated by resistor R. Let's see what is equal to PR. I'll write it. I square R. What is I is equal to? B square L or say BLU by R whole square into R. How much it is equal to? B square L square U square by R. So now tell me, like, you want more power. Power, I think all of you by this time power 10 watt, 20 watt, 30 watt. If you want more brightness, what you should do? You should move the rod with a more speed. That's all it says, no? Or how to increase the power? By increasing the field strength. Or by increasing the distance between rails. Theoretical questions, sir. Very dangerous. Students are good in all this mathematics. Suddenly what when they'll bring a problem, they say that for the brightness of the bulb to increase, the field strength should be increased. From how you are bringing all this, the equations are related like this. You see this, the power dissipated in the bulb. The brightness of the bulb depends on PR. The brightness of the bulb depends on what? B, field strength, length between the rails, and also the speed. If I move with more constant speed, if I move with more uniform speed, then this will have more brightness. See, I'm books, what happened, they just bothered about induced current and all. But basically, this is like a chapter where we are converting different forms of energy to finally what? To electrical energy. That's what the use of this chapter, no? What is the basic core idea of this chapter? Different forms of energy available in nature, how they can be converted it into electrical energy. Because finally, what we want electrical energy for application. So all the circuits, what you're picking up. So what they do, they'll convert energy from any form to electrical energy. That is a requirement. So this one background, you must have all these EMI chapters. What actually happened? The circuit, what happened? Converts energy from one form to another form. What is output here? It should be electrical energy. So shall I say mechanical power convert into electrical power? More than one options, they'll stress you with these statements. So this given circuit converts mechanical power to electrical power. So for that, we need a rod, a rails, and this resistor and this magnetic field. The energy conversion takes place here. So what is the energy conversion principle involved here? Mechanical power is converted into electrical power by the circuit. In every problem, do notice this. What form of energy is converted to what other form? Now, instead of giving velocity, instead of moving with a constant speed, let me drag with a constant force. Let's see what conditions will arise. Initially, the rod is attached at t equals 0, the rod is attached. Then again, what is the condition? So this is the there are many numericals are there. You can generalize them. You can generalize them. Okay, this is a rod at an instant of time, so there'll be a force F naught, and I can replace this rod by a cell of EMFE. Let V be the velocity of the rod, and from Lenz's law, the direction of induced current is towards left, so anti-clockwise, and BIL force will act here. then the rod will accelerate. Then what is I? I is equal to E by R, BLV by R. Then let's write the equation. So MA is equal to F naught minus BIL. And this is MdV by dt. F naught is a constant horizontal force that is applied along the rails. It is B. What is I? MdV by dt F naught B square L square V by R. You know enough of kinematics. From that, I'm writing dV by F naught minus B square L square VR by dT by M. Further simplification, F naught R you can integrate there only. Let me bring quotient of V, let it be 1. Initially it was a test. So this should be equal to log of F naught R B square L square minus V 0 to V is equal to minus of B square L square MR T. Upper limit, lower limit, substituting all this, I'll end up with B square L square F naught R. And I'll write one more step. Log of, this will be F naught R, log of F naught R B square L square. Let me write that lambda. This all, everything is lambda. So the equation for V will be one minus, no, so this should be F naught R B square L square 1 minus, just check it once. Okay, this one. So I got the expression for V. And finally, what will happen to the rod? What type of motion the rod will describe? What type of motion the rod is going to describe here? So shall we put like this? This is a graph. And what is VT? Terminal velocity. What is the terminal velocity? After long time, the speed of the rod will become constant, and how much equal to, I'll say, terminal velocity. Tell me, what about the energy relationship here? How that energy relationship that occurs? The power generated by action agent, what will happen for t less than zero and after long time? For t less than infinity, for t equal to infinity. At any time t, what is a power relationship here? Power generated by action agent, a part of that is utilized to increase the kinetic energy of the rod. Remaining power or the heat generated in the rest of the rod. After long time, what all the power generated by action agent will directly go to the rest of the rod because the kinetic energy of the rod remains constant. able to interpret? At any time t, I think I'll need one page. Where we are? I'll add one page, just wait. Okay, no. Anybody? The interpretation of power at any time t. In books, this interpretation of energy is missing, but in advance they're asking, you have to be careful. We don't have hardly anything that one, they just bothered with the mathematics. But in advance, often they're just trying to search student like, what is the idea of the energy involved here? At any time, the power generated by action agent should be equal to what? Power displayed in the register R plus rate of change of kinetic energy of the node. This for rod, no? This is for resistor. So then what is the equation how you write? F naught V should be equal to I square R plus dK by dt. After a long time, you say at steady state. After a long time, what all the power generated by action agent? They should be converted into this one. So F naught VT should be equal to I terminal. So what is IT? IT should be equal to BL VT by R. After a long time, what all the power action agent generates, that will be directly converted into power dissipated across HR. The interpretation of the energy is available there. Okay, second situation. The rod must be moved with constant angulation. The moving rod will behave like a cell. This is EMF, this is a resistor R. So what is the strict condition? The acceleration must be constant. So how that force I should apply it? Then the induced current I. BIL force. Let V be the velocity of the rod. Then again from I is equal to BLV by R. Directly I'm writing it. BLV by R. Then what is the equations we can write? F minus. What is given? The A naught. A naught is known. The rod will move with a constant acceleration. What should be the nature of force? Find the external force applied on the rod. Then V of T, I of T, and external power. He's asking to calculate all this. Now, this was that external force which I'm going to apply it. So initially the rod be at rest. Rod initially is at rest. Let's see that now B L V by R equal to MA naught. So this will be equal to B square L square V by R plus MA naught. What is V equal to further? Velocity of the rod at any time t. And it's a uniform acceleration. No? A naught is constant. It's telling constant acceleration. So for uniform accelerated motion, so what is velocity at any time t? as it is accelerates from rest. Shall we substitute this? So further this will be F external is equal to B square L square A naught T by R plus MA naught. Look at the type of force you should apply. You should apply a time-varying force. What is the minimum force you should apply? MA naught. The force that will be a function of time. What is the minimum force you should apply? That should be equal to MA naught. You should apply time-varying force. What about the power solve? Power generated by action agent. Again, P action, you can add. What is the velocity of the rod at any time t? Directly this much only. What is the expression for current? E by R, BL V by R, or BL A naught T by R. This is the expression for current. Power generated by action agent. P external should be equal to F external into V. Okay, I think all basic four cases I give. Rod given velocity release. Rod moved with a constant speed. Rod pulled by a constant force. Rod moved with a constant acceleration E naught. These are the basic conditions. Everywhere now, the ideas related to like this only will be revolving. Okay, instead of now the resistors, so let there be a long rail. I'll bring capacitor. Then what you are going to do this one at t equals 0, rod PQ is at rest and it is moved with constant acceleration A naught. Find the current I in the circuit. Resistance of rod and rails is negligible. There is no resistance in circuit. Now I brought, initially there is no charge in resistance of the rod and rails is negligible. Initial charge across capacitors, initial charge of capacitor is zero. Let M be the mass of the node. Now, from resistor, I brought capacitor. Like this, what happened? Different types of elements will be brought. So, finally, what is our goal? Resistor, capacitor, EMF, then frictional force, then I'll bring spring force, then I'll bring some string tension. Under action of all this, how that motion EMF numericals should be. That you have to neglect. Only the effect of external field is what you have to take it, because the dimensions of the of that one will be very small. You can neglect it. When a current I flows, due to that there'll be magnetic field produced. The dimensions of the element is such that the field produced by the current carrying wires will be negligible compared to external field, and you can neglect. If we ask you to consider, consider. Otherwise, you neglect it. No, what to do? Here, capacitor. Again, the idea is same. What is the idea? The moving rod will behave like a cell. I'll stick on to the basic thing. The moving rod will behave like a cell. Okay, there's a rod, PQ. The moving rod, I'm replacing it. This one, at an instant of time, let V be the velocity and it's have constant acceleration A naught. And from Lenz's law, how the induced current should flow anti-clockwise. And then at an instant of time, charge be the capacitor across, let it be Q. And what is E? E should be equal to BLV. But what is the basic problem here? How to bring current? So let's go back to capacitor chapter. So how this capacitor and cell are, they're parallel, no? So therefore, what is the charge across capacitor? Q equal to C into E, C, B, L, V. The charge in capacitor at any time t depends upon the velocity of the rod. I'll differentiate this, dq by dt. So C, B, L, dv by dt. dq by dt is what? Current. And what is dv by dt? Rate of change of speed of the rod, there should be the acceleration of rod. Oh, this is very important in all your numericals. Where there's a resistor, current will be proportional to velocity of the rod. Where there's a capacitor, current will be proportional to acceleration. Look at this, there's a current here, no? Find the current I in the circuit, this one is telling. Now, I should apply any external force for this. Yes, I should apply, no? On its own, it cannot move. Then a BL force will act here. Then what is the F external? Minus BIL equal to MA naught. What is I? I will be CBL A naught equal to MA naught. So this will be B square L. Some correction is there, I'll add up. I is what? CBL A naught, no? So this will be B square C A naught M A naught. So what is F external? Is equal to C B square L square plus M into A naught. A naught is given for us. This much of external force is what I should apply. Now let's talk about the energy conversion. What all power generated by external agent? What will happen to it? A part is used to increase the kinetic energy of the rod. And the remaining part is used to increase the potential across the capacitor. You see that what is this circuit? It converts mechanical power into a part of mechanical power into electrostatic energy. And the remaining, what happened is utilized to increase the kinetic energy of the rod. So what is the power conversion? What is the power relationship? dk by dt. du by dt. Electrostatic. I'll write across capacitor. The rate at which kinetic energy of the rod increases plus the rate at which the potential across capacitor increases. And this is what storing element, no? So I'm very energetic. I took so many nutritious food. So I'm having more mechanical energy. I want to preserve it. Can I take help of this circuit so that I can use later on? I'll just move the rod with constant acceleration. So my mechanical power, what will happen now? Will be given to a part of that will be stored in capacitor. Later on, when LCT is not there, I can use that energy in the capacitor. I can run my house. I can run my electrical appliances. So that's why you check now some in the website, no? There are some equipments are there in house, physical exercise equipments. When you do physical exercise, it electrical energy will be generated in that, and that will be stored later on. With the same electrical energy, you can use to run electrical appliances in your home. And future, I think this will be the future. No need to pay electricity bill. Just do physical exercises and electrical power generated. That electrical power generated will be sufficient to run your home. And anyway, windows will be there, solar cells you're going to implement on the floor. That's what the future. Of course, now they are a little bit costly. So with time, what happened when the cost of instruments will decrease? No, definitely what happened. Morning, get up, do exercise, generate energy in the capacitor, store it, and later on you can use for any applications. Okay, fine. So these are the some ways of asking. Now, capacitor comes, current will be proportional to. Now, let me bring a cell idea here. And there's a rod PQ, it's having resistance R, mass M. It is given initial velocity U. Let EMF of cell be E. So here, and these are the long rails. A rod PQ of, all of you able to hear me? Voice okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay then, a rod PQ of mass M, length L, and resistance R is given a initial velocity U and released at T equal to zero. Find the speed of rod at any time t. And now I brought a cell 0 and the cell is switched on. Find the speed of rod at any time t. No. So the resistor, capacitor, now and a cell which will have EMF. I'll give the velocity to the rod and I'll simultaneously switch on the cell. What conditions will arise here? So moving rod, we know moving rod should be like. Moving rod should be replaced with a cell. So this is the cell. And these are all introductory for you. Different a cell will come, inductors next, all. Resistor. Then tomorrow I'll introduce friction idea. Ideal cell. If it's having an internal resistance, put that small R here. So this is the velocity V at any time t. There's a magnetic field. So let's take this one. So how the induced current should be known? Definitely the velocity what I given, based on that, things will be dependent now here. Let's come for what is EMF induced? E equal to what you write. Motional EMF, BLU, the initial E naught. Let me begin with initial at T equal to zero only. At T equal to zero, this is what happens, no? Then whether current will flow or not will determine the value of U. Now I given velocity U such that current due to cell will flow like this, resistor R, and I'll bring it here. Hmm. It should be blocked here. So what is I1? I1 will be due to cell that will flow like this in this direction. This will be the I1. Due to EMF, induced EMF, E0, also there will be flow of current. And what will be the direction of that? Will be I2. So what is I1? We'll just work out individually first. So what is I1? I1 equal to E by R. What is R? R is the resistance of the rod. I1 equal to E by R. What about I2? I2 is equal to E0 by R. And further, this is equal to BLU by R. Now we have this one. So which current will be greater? That depends upon the value of U. No, am I right? The statement what I just quoted. So the value of U is such that I2 will be less than I1. Let's assume that I1 greater than I2. The resultant current, how it will be? The resultant current in the circuit will be towards right. So there's a cell here. And here, most of the EMF, and the resistance R. Let V be the velocity at any instant. This after some time t. At any time t, let I be the current, total current, let it be I. Then how the BIL force will act? The net resultant BIL will be towards right only, check it. The net resultant BIL will act here. Now you can ask question, where is that Lenz law? Where is that Lenz
law? Tight dresses.
Oh, ho, ho, ho. Somebody mute it. So where is that BIL force? The BIL force will act towards right only. The I is the resultant current. Due to I1 towards right, due to I2 towards left. So what is I1? I1 is a cause. And I2 is a, so I1 and velocity are cause. So what happened? I2 is a reaction. So with this, what you can expect? The speed of the rod will increase or decrease here? Will increase in this case. So let's write the resultant equations. Looking at the third diagram, did that any time t, no? MA is equal to BIL. So MdV by dt is equal to I is equal to I1 plus I2. What is I1? E by R. What about I2? BLV by R. So this will become now DV by BE plus B square L square V DT by MR. Then integrate this 0 to initial velocity given U. At any instant of time, let V be the velocity. Again, you'll get an expression. The velocity, this will be B square L square by E.
I1 minus I2, sir.
I1 minus I2, no? Okay, okay, this one. What is the final will be BL, BEL, so here one L will be there. I'm directly adjusting things. This will be the expression for the speed of the rod at any time t. After integrating all, lambda is some all constant terms will come. The speed of the rod will continuously increase. So let's talk about the energy now. I'm interested in that energy conversion. Finally, the speed of the rod, this will be the terminal velocity. And what is the terminal velocity? E by BL. So initially what will happen? The energy is supplied by action agent kinetic energy to the rod plus work done by the cell. What will happen to it? A part of it is utilized to increase the kinetic energy. And the remaining what happened will be used to overcome the heat across the, or remaining is used to generate heat across the resistor R. Okay, so now who will supply the energy now? The cell. The energy supplied by cell, a part of it is utilized to increase kinetic energy of the rod. Remaining what happened? Heat generated in the resistor R. In terms of power equation, what you write, E into I should be equal to dK by dt plus I square R, this one. So in terms of power, E into I should be equal to dK by dt plus I square R dt. So only I square R, power, no, it is. What all power generated by cell, a part is used to increase the kinetic energy of the rod, remaining what pen power dissipated across the resistor R. After long time, at t equal to infinity, after long time, what will happen? So what is the current? So let's after long time put t equal to infinity. Terminal velocity equal to E by BLV. So then what is the expression for current? The resultant current will be zero. I think these are some initial currents. Some are asking, what about these? These are initial currents. I'll put like this. Some are getting confusion with currents at any time t, and this one initials. Symbols I changed it. I1, I2, let it be at an instant of time. What is I? I should be I1 minus I2. And let's come for this. After long time, what will happen? The overall. After long time, put t equal to infinity. Then what is the terminal velocity will become equal to E by BL. Then what is the EMF induced across the rod? Will become equal to applied EMF. Initial velocity not equal to, here we are given, no? Oh, that also should be substituted. Okay, the equation, initial velocity should be taken care. Some modifications. So then the graph will change here. It should be like this. Okay, so some initial velocity U given, no? So things will be. So get expression, but things will be same. After long time, t equal to infinity, the current in the circuit will be zero. Then no power, no current, no power generated by cell, and there'll be EMF induced, no current flows, and there's no any power conversion will occur. After long time, the EMF of the EMF induced in the across the rod will become equal to that of the cell. So what is the net EMF? Will be zero. No current flows. And no, it will be generated. The rod will continue to move with a constant velocity. How to calculate the terminal velocity? I'll directly write it. Since I know this, I'll write it here. This will be the terminal velocity. If you want to check it, mathematics.
Initial velocity.
I didn't solve it. Solve it. What happened?
Initial velocity also will be
no. After a long time, that's all. No current flows. Then what all EMF generated across the rod should be equal to EMF generated across the cell, EMF of the cell. And this is what happens. Check it mathematics. Don't make a guess here. From this equation, I can directly say that put t equal to infinity, you'll end up with this one. plus you are saying
yes sir.
Okay this one, yeah, this is missing. U plus it will become okay. Solve this mathematics. Last one more circuit. I'll bring it. Three long rods of with resistance per unit length lambda are as shown. So this rod is fixed. We'll take different shaped loops now. Three long rods with resistance per unit lambda are as shown. Rod AB and BC are fixed. Rod PQ is moved with a constant velocity v as shown. So there's a uniform magnetic field is present. An uniform magnetic field B is switched on. Let M be the mass of the rod PQ. Find the I of T. Then next the force F of T acting on the rod or applied on the rod PQ. And external power generated by this one. So this is thing. Let me write F external. There's a uniform magnetic field. The rod AB and BC, they are fixed. What is the resistance per unit length? That would be lambda. So look at the loop now. There we had some constant loop like this. Now we have a situation of this kind. The velocity of the rod is maintained constant. So initially where the rod initially is present. Here this is the same rod PQ is initially present here. I will drag it from here. This is at time T. This is at t equal to 0. At t equal to 0, one point of the rod PQ is at origin. Then I'll drag with a constant velocity V. So at time t, I'm asking all these conditions. What is the current in the circuit? What force I should apply on the rod PQ? And what is the power generated by external agent? And what is lambda? Lambda is resistance per unit length. So now you go for different shaped loops. It was only rectangular, no? now we have some sort of like a triangle, and what happens to area? Area increases. First, let's go for Faraday's law. When EMF will be induced? When flux linking the loop changes. B bar is constant. Area is varying, no? Area is going to increase. Area of that triangle is going to increase. Area of the triangle is going to increase. The flux is varying. So EMF will be induced. Due to that, induced current will flow. So let's how to calculate all these things. So this moving rod will behave like a cell. Yes, still the idea is same. But calculation of flux is something very important in this case. No. So this A, P, rod PQ is there. No? So let me take this is P1. I'll call P1 as Q1. The point P1 and Q1 of the rod are in contact with the rods AB and with AB and BC. Let me do one thing. So let me take this is X. This distance, let it be X. What is V equal to? Dx by dt, I can write it now. The first assumption, V equal to dx by dt. I know X, this is 90 degrees. So this angle should be how much? 45 degrees. So what should be the, and this should also be 45 degrees. So call this is O. So P1O and Q1O, they must be equal. And it should also be equal to X. And what is X in turn? X should be equal to Vt, no? Because it is moved with a constant velocity. So V is a constant. Direction is maintained constant and magnitude is maintained constant. So constant velocity is telling. So therefore, what is X should be equal to Vt. So I'm able to define the overall, the length of the perimeter of the rod. What is P1, B, Q1? So let's calculate the flux linking the loop. Flux linking the loop should be equal to B into perimeter of the loop. Or area, I should take it. I think I should take area, no? Area of triangle. Area of triangle, P1, B, Q1. What should be the area? Half into base, BQ1, height, BP1. Now what should be the BQ1? Root X. So the X root 2. This. Yeah. Then what is BP1? This should be X root 2. Because OQ1 is equal to X, no? This is, so finally this will be BX square, I'll get it. This is the flux linking. And what is in turn X is equal to? X should be equal to VT. Flux should be equal to B VT O square or B V square T square. Now I have flux. I'll differentiate this. Differentiation, this one, d phi by dt. Only magnitude I'm predicting. So this will be 2v v square t. Can we predict direction of current? Go back
sir,
to
it
the...
It will be bx square by 2, sir. Flux. Bx square by 2.
Root 2, root 2.
Okay.
Now there's the EMF induced. So from Faraday's law, what should be the direction of induced current? Negative flux increases d phi negative, EMF induced positive. So the induced current, in fact, should flow like this. It is initiate of time. This is induced current. So now I know E. Can we predict R, the induced current I? So what should be I is equal to E by total resistance of circuit. Of the loop, what is the 2b v square t? What is the resistance? Lambda is the resistance per unit length. No? So lambda into so perimeter of the loop. It's a very popular problem where student must different shaped loops will come, so and you should manage that one. So perimeter is what? BQ1 BP1 plus P1 Q1. I think what should be the values? BQ1 should be equal to root x, already we have. Or say x root 2. BP1, BQ1 also, x root 2. And this should be equal to how much? 2x. Length P1, Q1, how much it should be equal to? 2x. I'll show total problem. It'll be easier for you. Try to see now. I think everything is visible. So after solve,
root 2x, sir.
Which one, ma?
P1, Q1.
P1, Q1 is what? X plus x, I'm writing it. P1O plus Q1O.
Okay, sir. Okay, sorry, sir.
Okay, ma. Yeah. This should be x. X will come out. So this will be 2 root 2 plus 2. So lambda. And what is x? X in turn you are going to write Vt. To also get eliminated. Let's see that. Okay, we have only this much. Constant current flows. By looking at diagram, now we feel something will end up with very big mathematics. A constant I current. So constant. So once you know current constant, things are all are easier, no? Now tell me what should be the this expression for current. And then what should be the force I should apply? The external force I should apply on the rod should be equal to BI into P1 Q1 B. P1 Q1 should be equal to 2x. So B square V, 2x is Vt. So this is the value of 2b square v square t by lambda into root 2 plus 1. So this much of external force I should apply. What about power? F external into v. So getting this method now, so different shaped loops will be coming for you, like a parabolic shaped rod PQ. Here I took this one, no? It's like a straight rod I took it, some curve, some parabolic. So different shaped rods now will be moving. Now we have to calculate the flux linking the loop. Then as usual, so we have to proceed. So don't bother the negative sign. Direction of induced current, take help of directly Lenz's law. Focus on only the magnitude by using Faraday's law. This is one easiest method to avoid that negative signs. Because in the mathematics, no, the sign here and there will trouble you. So what I suggest, get magnitude by Faraday's law, direction by the Lenz law. You know that negative flux increases, d phi by t negative, EMF induced will be positive. So therefore the current will be anticlockwise. Okay, I'll stop it here. Thank you all of you. Okay, thank you all of you. Take care. Bye. See you.